His words reach thousands of readers every day. Words laced with satire and biting wit.
I'm just temporary relief. That's what I give people. I'm like an Advil. I try to make people laugh or at least see the world a little bit differently because I look at the newspaper as a chronicle of human failure.
It's that human failure that's kept Frank Cerabino churning out columns for 16 years at the Palm Beach Post.
I'm not here to instruct people how they should behave. I like bad behavior because, frankly, it keeps me in business. You know, if there were no commissioners that misbehaved, I wouldn't be able to write about them. I don't want to write about people doing things they should do.
I recently spent some time with Cerabino in the Post newsroom.
Oh. Isn't it nice?
It's a little messy. It's a little messy.
I was actually thinking of cleaning it up because I knew you were here. You know?
What's
that? And I was thinking of getting the dust balls out and updating the pictures so like my kids, they see like right now, see, he's 20 years old right now. That shows you how neglect. I'm not a very big nester.
But at home, it's all about family. Married for 27 years, Cerabino and his wife have three children, ages 20, 17, and 8. Cerabino was the oldest of four children in a large Italian-American family on Long Island.
See, when I grew up, I always thought, to me, jokes and being funny was like part of being a human being. My father was a prankster, a joker. He just kind of did crazy things. Like we'd go to the Westbury Music Fair, which was like a theater in Long Island, and he would go in the bathroom and turn the lights out on everybody, you know, and I thought that was normal behavior, you know.
His parents pushed him to succeed in school. Cerabino went to the U.S. Naval Academy and majored in economics. It was during his time at sea on an aircraft carrier that his life really started to change.
The forms of entertainment on a ship in those days was you could play cards or you could read. So I played cards, you know, for as long as I could stand it. And then eventually, out of desperation, I picked up a book.
Out of that grew a love of reading and then writing. Soon came marriage, graduate school at Northwestern, and a job at the Miami Herald. In 1989, he came to the Palm Beach Post as a reporter, but got his break as a columnist during the William Kennedy Smith trial in 1991. No one is immune from his satirical attacks. Some of his favorite targets? Local politicians.
I like Mayor Frankel, and I tell you why. Because she has an unfiltered mouth.
People who live in Boca Raton, which includes Cerabino himself.
If it's competitive living, whether you're going shopping or you're going out to the park or whatever it is, it's just people just trying to win at all times.
And condo commandos.
And you get a 75-year-old guy that still needs to be in charge. He's going to take over the condo board, and he's going to willingly make life miserable for all those people in his condo. This is some fan mail here.
Cerabino gets a lot of it.
I am at the point where I cannot take it anymore, and your column in the Sunday paper has pushed me over the edge.
Even the rich and famous have something to say.
And this is a letter from Donald Trump complaining about me. I have that up here.
Oh, what's that say?
Oh, it says I'm an ingrate or something.
Cerabino wouldn't have it any other way.
I want to be one of those old people I make fun of. That's what I'm really looking forward to. I'm really looking forward to be a character in somebody else's column that's just like mine. That's what I really want. I want somebody to say, that crotchety old guy, you know, that's, that's what I want to be.